a touch of frost here. The Yakons don't handle frost very well. But closer to the ground, it was protected. I've got some more over in the other garden. Let's go check those out. Here's some elephant garlic that I didn't harvest. I missed it. That's okay, we'll let them grow there, see what happens. Maybe they'll go to seed next year. Yeah, those Yakons made it. The shed here probably gave them enough protection. Cool. I'm preparing to plant elephant garlic in this bed that last year grew garlic. And I failed to harvest a couple of cloves, a couple of bulbs with cloves, and they already started growing. They look pretty healthy. I think I'll just trim off the leaves. I'll eat them for lunch today, and I'll replant those cloves someplace, but not here because this is elephant garlic, which is a member of the leek family. We're not planting garlic over garlic, which I don't think there's going to be a problem with that with my fertile soil, but I'm going to rotate anyway. So this is the first bed, and over here is the second bed. That isn't prepared yet for planting. I have a pot full of potatoes. I'm assuming we got potatoes in it. I don't know, maybe not. When I grew potatoes in that pot, I'm going to be dumping that out over the top of the cloves after I plant them. We'll see if we have a potato harvest, and plus we're building the bed up a little bit again. All right, I've got 38 cloves in this bed, and it's I'm guessing 8 feet long. You can see all little holes here. That all represents a clove. I planted these very densely. These are potatoes. I'll put it that way. Oop, got two potatoes, three potatoes already. Yeah, that's three more than I thought I was gonna get. Here's another one. Here's some more. 2, 3, 4, 5. Little purple Peruvians. Here's some more. So this was compost that I made in 2020, and then now I've used it to grow some potatoes, and finally it's ending up on the garden bed. And it's really nice soil. There's probably hardly any weed seeds in it, because basically in that composting process the soil gets sterilized, in that the bacteria, the aerobic bacteria that I'm growing, eats all the weed seeds. So there, I think there's some potatoes already in here because I planted just some potato shoots in here, and I'm just going to see what overwinters and comes up. I've done that before with success. So I wouldn't mind having a few potatoes growing in my leek bed. So that looks really nice, but there's one more step. And that is covering it with chicken wire so the squirrels don't eat the cloves. I've already had it where they didn't even eat the cloves, they just dug them all up. It's like they got nothing else to do. But to be a pain. That's a bed with 38 elephant garlic cloves planted in it. It's ready to grow. Now, check back with you when I'm done with the last one. And this again is skirret that I have hidden underneath hardware cloth because the voles will get it. Voles will dig that stuff up. First 2 years I had a grace period, but now they figured it out. Maybe if I kill enough of them, they have to refigure it out again, but I'm not taking that chance. I'm covering it up. Okay. Looks good. And we got some nice garlic that we harvested too. To boot, an extra. All right. It is planted with 23 of the best elephant garlic cloves that I had. The biggest, the fattest, the meanest. And I spaced them apart. Much wider than the ones on this bed, which are just the smaller, actually they weren't smaller, I call them medium cloves. There's 39 in this little bed, there's 23 in this larger bed. And now we're going to check to see if there's any potatoes in this pot. Might not be any, I don't know. Here's the harvest from the first pot. That's not too bad for growing in a pot. Those are purple Peruvians, they're supposed to be that small. These are the only ones that I really had consistent production in pots. Matter of fact, they grow a little better in pots than out in some of the beds that I planted. Not all of them. I kind of noticed that. And these actually overwinter a little bit in the ground. I've got a bed now that's had purple Peruvian potatoes overwinter in the bed for 7, maybe 8 years now. I've been planting back the really tiny ones, and those are the ones that are growing. The really big ones, for some reason, I don't think they make it. Remember, this part of the bed now has potatoes planted in it. So we're gonna see if any of those make it. Ooh, there's a big one. That might be the biggest one right here. Purple Peruvian. Well, I guess that doesn't really give it justice, all that dirt around it. And another, oh, this one might even be bigger. Another one that's pretty nice. So we're doing something that is taught in permaculture, that one action has multiple benefits. And what we're doing here is we've aged the compost that I made in 2020 through the summer, through the season of 2021, and we grew a crop of potatoes in it along with aging it. And in the past you'd see me empty these pots out in the wheelbarrows, and then I would cut the wheelbarrow someplace. Well, now I'm using the wheelbarrow to bring the pot here full of potatoes, but then I'm dumping it right on the bed. Now, I eliminated that one transfer from the wheelbarrow to the bed, into the wheelbarrow and into the bed. Well, this way, I dumped the pot right in the bed. And I've already proven that this compost really doesn't need to be aged, but I'm using it also to prove that I can grow crops right in the compost in a pot. There. All I gotta do is cover it with chicken wire and put some bricks on the chicken wire, and this is a done deal. Quite as many as the last pot, the bigger ones. So here I am. I've learned the hard way. Now I'm spending the time to put chicken wire over it. Right here we have a finished project. It took me maybe an hour. I planted 23 of the largest cloves in this front bed and 38 of the medium cloves in the middle bed, and there is a bed of skirret along the wall. The skirret is protected with hardware cloth from voles, and the cloves of elephant garlic are protected from squirrels. And then I harvested some garlic that I failed to get when I pulled them out in August, and they're sprouting, and I decided I'm gonna go ahead and eat these. They're sprouted, they're fresh, greens and all, I'm eating them right now because I got plenty of cloves to plant. All right. That is the end of another fine episode of Permaculture on Demand. Time to harvest the sweet potatoes. I'll show you, a plant's got busted by the frost here. See that? Some leaves made it, but most of them are out. I'm not expecting too much, but we'll see. Nothing so far. A tag. They were planted late. Something might come up yet. We'll see. Here's one. Cut it with the shovel. Parsnip. Guess we can take that out of here too. Oh yeah, that's a dandy. Look at that one. Nice parsnip. Another nice parsnip. Oh, dandy. Take this parsnip too. They will store a long time in the fridge. Oh, there's two of them here. Side by sides. Little bitty sweet potato. That looks like a real nice plant right here. There's gotta be potatoes in that one. Something broke. There's one right here. Ooh, there's a nice one. We're gonna get a taste. We'll bake that up on a nice cold night in the next couple weeks. That'll warm us up. I never did grow many really nice sweet potatoes up here. Up here in the northern, 45 degree. 44 degree north. But this will be good for a couple of meals. Can't ask for much more. Just a couple of meals here, a couple of meals there. Pretty soon we got some. Here they are. Parsnips and sweet potatoes. My life is now complete. I transformed this garden bed, which I called main crop garden number 4, into a bed of honeyberries and asparagus. And the reason why is because I've got a roof over to keep the birds out from stealing the honeyberries. I've got 3 in each bed. I can put a fourth one here yet. This I'm going to leave empty because I got a big honeyberry in the corner. I need access. But I have some heirloom parsnips in here I want to grow next year and get the seed out of them. So I've got some cleanup work here in this corner to do this next spring. And this is pretty much a wrap. Just let her grow. This barrel is now full of water courtesy of my big water tank. I think it's almost empty. I bet you it was thermal siphoning. Sure, that baby's plumb empty. I think that thing thermosiphons right out of there. Ah, that's cool. All right, time to flip this on its end. Time to pick this pepper. I'm playing chicken now with it with all these cold nights. One of these times it's gonna frost. It'll be shot. Ooh, I think it's shot already. Oh, I'm too late. Well, maybe this half here will be all right. Darn it. These two Yakon plants were installed late, probably late spring, and they still managed to make a crop, and they're growing in the shade, and I left a couple of them. These are the three largest, but there's probably four or five, probably three in one, two in the other, that I left, along with the little nodules that are going to send a shoot up next year. This is my compost right here. That's my compost. I've done this a couple years in a row, and a lot of years in a row, and it's always been successful at overwintering Yakon in my basement.